Hey everybody, welcome back. What you're looking at right now is a collaboration build with Oak Sim Studios. I'm going to link his video in the description box. Basically, a couple of weeks ago, he approached me and asked me if I would want to do a collab. And of course I said yes. I was so excited that he asked me to do a collab. He's so talented. You guys have to check out his channel. He has lots of different things on it. He's super funny. He makes really, really pretty builds. And yeah, I was really excited he wanted to work with me. So we decided to do something for the Snowy Escape Pack. And originally the idea was to do two townhouses, and then it kind of developed from there. And so we basically each did about half the lot. And I think it came out so cool. I think it really looks like a city street. I mean, I don't know how accurate it really would be to, you know, like a Japanese city of some sort. But that's kind of what I had in mind when I started building. And I wasn't sure exactly what to do. I knew I was going to do an actual townhouse with an apartment in it and everything, like a home. And then I didn't know what else to do. And it was actually his suggestion, and I'm so happy that he suggested it. But he said, what about a cat cafe? And I thought that would be so cute and so fun. And we have that cat wallpaper that we got with Snowy Escape. It's a tile. And I can't imagine that I would ever use it again in any other build unless I was doing like a crazy cat lady's house that had that in her bathroom or something ridiculous like that. I don't know. So I figured I might as well use the wallpaper. So you'll see when I get to decorating the inside. I had a lot of fun with it, and I made like this little rooftop area with a trellis over it. And I just want to say, I don't think I mentioned it in yesterday's video, but we got so many beautiful debug plants in the new Snowy Escape Pack that I really, really love. I could tell they're already going to be some of my favorites. It's just, there's a lot of really lush greenery that just kind of fits in with any style build, and you can really, you know, work with it really easily, and I really liked it. So I used a lot of that. And then inside the cat cafe, which you can see here, I started to work on, I made little shelves going around the top, you know, for where the cats would be. And then I thought about it when I was looking at pictures on Pinterest, and they have so many cat cafes. This is like a big thing. So a lot of them are big and very spacious on the inside. So for a little bit, I was questioning if I should use the other building instead, but I thought this was perfect for the space that it is. And I imagine that there's got to be smaller ones in a city block of some sort, something like that. So I just, you know, had fun with it. I tried to, you know, incorporate as many different items for cats as I could, and I put these little cubbies, and I thought that was really cute. And then upstairs on the trestle, upstairs on the porch with the trellis above it, I put you know, like cat scratching posts and things like that, and just tried to make it feel really cozy and like a fun place to hang out. So then for the building next door to it, I created this three-story apartment. This would be a good apartment for two Sims. I put, you know, I could only fit one bedroom in there. I'm sure if I had like tried harder to fit more, I could have, or I could have expanded it. But I really like this sort of tight-knit little community, little city block. So I just wanted to leave it the way it was. And I put a little driveway in the back, and I just put a little cute little garden in the front, and I kept the interior pretty simple, not as much clutter as I would normally use in a build. And it's very modern. Like, I really love the way the furniture looks from the new pack. I can't say enough good things about it. I haven't found anything so far yet that I really have to complain about it, except, I mean, there's a couple of things. I don't know if I'm ever going to build like a snow skiing place, or I mean, maybe I will. Maybe I'll build a ski lodge one day and then I'll use all those items. But there is a lot of items in the game that I wouldn't use unless I was building something specific. So we'll see if I find some new uses for some of the things. But for 95% of the items in the game, I would think that they're a really great asset to The Sims as a whole. So other than that, I'm working on content for you guys for next week already. This week, you know, you have a lot of videos coming up, so keep your eyes out for that. I hope to see you guys at the other videos. And let me know what you guys think of this one down in the comments. Like I said, just a reminder, you can check out Oak Sim Studios videos in the description box down below. And I hope you all have a great day. Bye.
Thank you.